Hey guys, I'm just gonna make a real quick video. First, on a side note, I've kind of found the Instagram videos. I didn't really pay attention that they were there, and I made a couple minisodes on Instagram. I'm talking like 60-second little clips. So if you're not on Instagram already, go ahead and hop on there if you want to see more special content and videos that you won't find on the YouTube channel. So this is the YouTube channel, and I just want to follow up on an Instagram video I made last night. You remember I was trying the I put on the Forester mufflers. That was a joke, guys. I was just laughing at you guys. Oh, that looks bad. That looks shitty, dude. It was a joke, man. I needed them to get to my folks' house. It wasn't like I was gonna keep them. Nice look at that bad boy right there. The best thing that's happened to my cars, plural, in the last like 3 months is probably the tips on the Forester. It just completely. I like that look. The shape, I mean. It isn't terrible. It's pretty freaking even since I used the template. That's perfect right there. I still might put the stock Forester. I don't know, the power issue. The stock Forester mid-pipe back on, because the sound just isn't good. This is, in my opinion, this is just for the look. So I wouldn't lose anything with the look. There, this light has to be on me. I wouldn't lose anything in the look if I put back the stock Forester mid-pipe with a bigger resonator, and it'd just be quiet, but it would look good. It was already nice and quick and fun, you know. I don't really care about a tiny bit extra sound that isn't sporty sound, like I keep saying. Okay, enough of that. So the WRX, oh, I cleaned it last night. Holy crap, look at that. Even my tires with the 3M tire protector. Wow. Even though it actually dried up a bit, I'm gonna put more tire protector on it. I'm gonna show you that in a minute. What the hell not? Might as well. All right. Why did I even come out here? What am I talking about? Oh, I'm talking about the mufflers. Okay, so that's just how they came out. Whatever. I just painted all the backs black, and I finally took 20 minutes and cleaned these tips finally. I mean, they're gonna get black in, you know, a few days, whatever. And if you remember, I do not have the yellow, I don't have the yellow hangers anymore. I'm not freaked out about it right now. The difference is you can totally clean it now. Before, you can't even get your fingers in there to clean it. You know, of course, it doesn't look as nice and tucked, but because it's black, it doesn't need to be as tucked, and I have way more access to clean them. I don't know. I'm fine with it for now. I'm definitely not gonna put those yellow ones back in because they were a little bit worn out. Oh, I just got an Instagram notification or something. Oh no, that's a Hampton Roads dude messaging me on this Facebook for the Hampton Roads Subaru group. That's a closed group, and it was kind of hard to get in. Everybody's all suspicious and everything, but I finally got accepted into that. Okay, so that's that. You know, there's pitting or whatever. That's just stock. It's a shitty stock muffler, but some of the black parts, you know, really came out nice, really glossy. So I'm perfectly happy with that. So now to go round robin to my other issue that I talked about last night. So I had the Subaru mufflers on. They're hanging up here. I was really surprised with how nice they were as far as sound, I'm talking about. I really preferred the sound of these Forester mufflers to the ones I got now. It was killer. I would do anything to have the sound of these with the dual tips. It quieted it down. So first, these Forester mufflers have to be built differently because it was a lot quieter with these than those. Must have, you know, it's probably meant to be quieter. It's not a sport muffler. But you know, here where I have a little roarer tone at almost any RPM with these, this took the edge off it and took out the growl that can get annoying from time to time, but it still had sporty tone. That is not the same sound as if I put the STI pipe on there, mid-pipe, like I always do, you know, where I didn't like that too much. It was too boring. that did not sound as good as this. So leaving the WRX mid-pipe is the key for my sound. And like a muffler change, I got to figure something out with these. That's my goal now. I'll be thinking about this for weeks until I figure something out. And the thing was, I took off these screws. I was hoping that the tip would slide off and I could buy some sweet black tips. Boom, I'm done. Not so. I took out the bolts. This thing isn't budging, so I don't know what the hell's going on. It might be welded, but why would they use a bolt if it was welded? I don't know. But I'd really love to put some, you know, clean these up, paint them, get some really killer dual tips that are easier to clean, have the sound I want, the look I want, everything there. So if anybody has had a lot of muffler experience and they know anything about these tips and how they work and stuff, I just don't know. Is that a double? Oh, see there's a lip there? I wonder if, you know what? I wonder if I pry it, I'm gonna start denting everything up. I bet it's such a tight fit, and I bet this inner pipe is probably the muffler, and this outer super tight pipe, see it looks like it's almost one piece, but it's not. If I could tap it and tap off the whole tip, and I'd be left with perfect tips to attack, to buy some really good aftermarket double tips, beautiful MagnaFlows or something, and then attach them somehow, however they attach, paint it black, maybe even get the black tips I've always wanted. If they're a push-on, it would work. Oh my God, what a dream. Bottom line, the car felt faster with those. I know that's placebo, but it just was so smooth and quiet with a little bit of tone, not as much as it has now, which can get annoying from time to time. So that's where I'm focused next, to somehow get those mufflers on my WRX with better tips, with dual tips. So I think that's all I have to talk about. Out of breath, it's probably all my breathing issues. Because I'm always so, I've got so much in my mind all the time. There's the WRX resonator, rusty, and you know, just for a fun project sometime, I'm gonna take my polishes and I'm gonna cherry that out and get rid of all, it's probably all surface. I can get rid of most of that rust with some rubbing, and that's a fun project for me, just to kind of polish out the mid-pipe and get it clean. You can see my WRX J-pipe is pretty cherry, so it must be that this ran in the winter is why it's so rusty, because that one's cherry back there, and it hasn't been on the car in Virginia at all. Yeah?
I'm here to take a picture of an import
frame. What?
I'm taking a picture of it so I can put stickers on it.
You're taking a picture of my pipes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There.
There you go. Now put stickers in your picture of my exhaust pipes. Cool. All right. Oh God, let me stop it for a minute. I'm losing my train of thought. All right, I'll just finish up with a little promotion. If you stayed this long, then you know, you won't mind it. If you've already left, then you won't see it anyway. A lot of my eBay stuff sold. Not a lot, maybe half of it. What? So I sold my, and these are like 3157 bulbs that are not for Subarus, so it's kind of tricky to sell. Where are you going? Why are you out here without shoes? Go get your shoes. I sold the white 31. Look at all those birds. God damn it. Oh, a tree update. Go inside. The owners have agreed to take down the entire tree. Whoa. There's a lot of birds in there. And don't be like a tree hugger. The reason this tree is dead, it's been confirmed. The tree people came. There's no reason to keep it up here. And all this is gonna be gone. Oh my God, it's gonna be beautiful. I can't wait, I can't wait. Then I don't worry about the birds on that tree over there because that's in the other yard. So anyway, that's coming in the next month. The tree's coming down, man. It's gonna be awesome. God, I lost my train of thought again. See, that's the life of Last Human's Garage. Any bird crap up there, you tell me. I did clean it last night after I detailed my car. Well, I washed it. I just hosed off a few spots and now they're back again. So the birds are always crapping little mini poops on there. What is that? Oh, my camera spotted me out here and alerted me on my phone immediately. So watch out. This is under surveillance 24 hours a day from anywhere on my phone. eBay. I sold both my lift kits. Yes, for a ridiculous sad loss. I think I sold them for 60 a piece. I had 300 in them. So I lost 2/3 of my money. Whatever. I needed to get rid of them. I do have 2 JDM A-Star trunk and license plate bulbs on eBay again, half price of new. They're good JDM A-Star with thick wire, just 2 bulbs. It's like, I don't know, around $4 plus shipping. That's half price of new. If anybody needs those will fit these cars. They'll fit any car really. What else do I got? Hold on. I guess one of the other things I got is I still got that Subaru base radio for Forester, WRX, or Impreza, any of those. I can't get rid of that. Damn it. I paid like $110, $120. I can't even get like $40 for it. That kind of sucks. I could use the extra funds right now. What else? Oh, for you Virginia folks, I'm looking for a vinyl roof sponsor. I posted in a couple Facebook groups too. I'm looking for a special deal here. And I want to showcase a vendor on my channel. Maybe go with a black vinyl roof. I'm not sure if that might be too much black for my look. You know, it's already so black. But I think it'll look good. It'll look all right. It'll be a lot of black. I hope it's not overpowering, but that's what I'm thinking about right now. One last thing, my fogs still did, last night I showed it on a video on Instagram, my fogs still had condensation, so they're not airtight or nothing, or they're not working quite right. Right now they might be okay, but I definitely want to do Morimoto LED fog housings at some point. You guys know, if you guys, a bunch of you did the XB kit, is that the one? There's like there's T-type, I don't know, all these different types. Is the XB the type we use first off? And second off, does it have the connector done, or does it come with a crimper and or pins that you gotta put into your connector? I've seen all these pictures, I don't know how it comes. Of course, I'd like it ready to go. I don't wanna have to take out pins out of a stock connector and all that crap. So anyway, let me know. That's about it for now. I got not a lot of car stuff going on today. I don't need to. I just got it super clean and cherry. So that's about it. I gotta go.